Okay, so in this episode, I'm going to show you how to make this bouncing ball, but the main purpose of this is I want to go over the principle of squash and stretch. In the industry, it's called S&S. And the definition for squash and stretch is the principle of applying a contrasting change of shape from a squash pose to a stretch pose, or vice versa, to give the feeling of fleshiness, flexibility, and life in animation. Give your animations, whether it's a ball or a character, any kind of shapes, sometimes even text, more of a lifelike feeling by applying the principle of squash and stretch. Now, we'll revisit this definition later and apply it to the actual movement of this ball. So let's go ahead and create our ball. Right click in the area that's to the left of our timeline, we're going to add in a shape layer. And within this shape layer, I'm going to add in a group. And the reason why I want to add in a group is because I want to use the group's transform properties. Notice whenever you add in a group, you get transform properties. And you also have transform properties of your layer. So I'm going to use the group transform properties to animate our ball and then use a layer transform properties to move the ball around on our screen. So let's click on our ball group right here. Let's add in an ellipse. Give that ellipse a fill. I'm just going to change the color of this because I don't really like the default red that After Effects gives to shapes. I'm doing all of this either from the add button right here or from your toolbar. You also have all of these options that you can manipulate your shape layer from. So I'll be using both. Just know that you can do that from either one. You have the same exact options. So another reason why I want to use a group is because now I can make my ball whatever size I'd like. I'm going to make this 200 pixels. And then I can use the transform properties, and it's just much easier to do the math. So our scale is set at 100%. So no matter what size I make our shape layer here, notice our transform property scale of our group remains at 100%. So it just makes it a little bit easier if you do it in that way. Okay, so now if you haven't already done so, hit the quotation marks, and that will bring up your safe margins. And so I want to set my scale in a squash pose. Let's close this up, and I'm going to use the transform property. So let's unconstrain our scale. I want to make this 130 on the X value and 70 on the Y. So this is our squash pose. Now let's just take our position and move it down here so it rests right here on this line. We're going to put a keyframe for position and scale. And now you can hit U and it will only show your keyframes. These are the only values that we're going to be manipulating. Shift page down 1-2 times, and then I'm going to move my position up. And we want our scale at the topmost position to be equal. So we'll put this back at 100 on the X, 100 on the Y. And I'm just going to move this down so that way it's the same distance from the edge of our comp as our squash pose is. So it's going to be resting on this top line right here. Then let's shift page down 2 more times, take these first set of keyframes, copy and paste. And I'm just going to loop this by selecting the N button. We're going to be using a loop out expression. You have to have an odd number of keyframes. As of right now, we have 3 sets of keyframes. We'll eventually have 5, but for a loop out expression to work, you need to have an odd number of keyframes, and the first set has to be the same as the last set. So see, third set of keyframes, and notice our first set is identical. And that makes sense because the loop out expression makes your animation repeat forever. So you want your first and last set of keyframes to be the same. So now if we watch this playback, this is very basically what we're going for right here. Now it's going to look a lot better as we start to add in more keyframes and we affect the speed of those keyframes. But this is a basic idea. So we go back to the beginning of our layer and shift page down once, we'll go right in the middle of these 2 keyframes at the 10th frame. So at this point, we're going to do our stretch pose. Let's take this first keyframe, copy and paste. And notice our values are 130, 70. Well, to do the stretch pose, we need to do the inverse of that. So this 130 value becomes 70, and the 70 value becomes 130. And this looks a little bit exaggerated, but it makes more sense and looks better while it's animating. And now we want to take this keyframe, we will copy that, and shift page down twice to go in between these 2 keyframes and just paste. So the second and fourth keyframe are identical, and our first and last set of keyframes are identical. Okay, so now if we watch that playback, this is the basic movement we're going to be going for, but notice all of our keyframes are linear, so we need to change that and also affect the speed of these keyframes. So let's stop that animation, and we're going to select all of these and select F9 to make them all easy ease or Bezier. Watch that playback, and it's got a little bit more life to it. Looks a little bit more like how we want it to look. But I want to do one more thing. If we select this middle position keyframe, open up our graph editor, and then just pull this over the left and the right, so that way these handles are moving away from this middle keyframe, watch that play back. So now, if you want this to be less exaggerated, what you would do is just adjust the values of your squash and stretch scale. So, see, I have mine set to 130, 70. So I'm going to make this, we'll say 120 and 80. So then let's make our stretch pose. We'll make that 80, 120. So now we need to copy this keyframe, go to our fourth one, because we want those to be identical, then also copy this first set, and then make the fifth set identical to the first. Watch this playback. You can also enable your motion blur to get something that looks a little bit better. With this kind of animation, I always like to enable my motion blur. I have everything separated by 10 keyframes. So let's make it where they're separated by 5 keyframes. Select all of these keyframes, holding down Option or Alt. Just move this last one until your second keyframe is at the 5th frame. Loop that area right there. Now we get something that looks like that. Now notice if I stretch out my work area, it's going to bounce and stop. So we want that now add our loop out expression. So it's Option or Alt click onto position and start typing loop, arrow down to loop out and hit return. Right click on position, choose copy expression only, go to scale and then paste that. So now we have loop out on both position and scale. I'm just going to open this all the way to the end of our comp and watch it play back. Now, I mentioned at the beginning of this tutorial that I wanted to use the layers transform properties to move the ball around on the comp. So if you select a layer, hit P for position, bring our position where it's off screen, and we want to put a keyframe there, and then go to maybe, we'll say, 7 seconds, and then we're going to move our position over off screen on this side. If you want to just watch it play back quicker, just disable the motion blur here, so that way you still retain the motion blur, but it's not going to be rendering that. So squash and stretch is the principle of applying a contrasting change of shape from a squash pose to a stretch pose or vice versa to give a feeling of fleshiness, flexibility, and life in animation. So all we're doing is manipulating the scale of our ball as it moves up and it moves down. You can apply it to characters, you can apply it to shapes, you can even apply it to text. You would be amazed at how applying these principles will give your motion graphics and animation just that much more life. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.